Hi everybody, Eric Wolf here from Airwolf 3D. Today I'm going to talk to you about the strength of commonly and not so commonly 3D printed materials. Specifically, we'll be talking about PLA, nylon 910, ABS, and polycarbonate. We'll test each material by printing a common hook and then loading the hook until it fractures. The hook that holds the most weight will correspond to the material that has the highest tensile strength. And to back it up, we'll pull some information from a great article from 3dprint.com, specifically talking about the tensile strength of all of the different 3D printed materials that we will discuss today. To keep it interesting, we set up a fun experiment using our 3D printed hooks to pick up a tractor tire that weighs 150 pounds, loaded with hundreds of more pounds of weights from our local and favorite gym, Precision Fitness in Costa Mesa, California. So let's get on with it and start talking about our 3D printing materials. The most popular desktop filament is polylactic acid, or as we commonly refer to it, PLA. We print PLA at about 190 to 200°C with a bed at 60°C, and we apply Wolf Bite Nano to that bed to help with adhering it. The Wolf Bite Nano adheres the PLA to the glass printing surface, and after the print's done, it's easy to remove the part. Now, some commonly 3D printed objects with PLA are toys and figurines. PLA is used all the time in schools. It's environmentally friendly, it's compostable, and it prints easily at low temperatures in all sorts of different environments. It's also pretty strong. You may be surprised at just how strong it is. So let's check the video. Pretty darn impressive. PLA survived up to a 285 pound lift. With a small hook and printing PLA, to be able to survive 285 pounds is pretty darn impressive. Truth be told, we were surprised with the strength of PLA. However, when we look back at that article we mentioned earlier from 3dprint.com, PLA has a very high tensile strength. In fact, it is rated to 7,250 pounds per square inch. This is a strong material. But with that comes a caveat. There's a reason PLA is mostly used for toys and figurines. PLA, by its nature, degrades in sunlight and degrades in an outdoor environment. So with that said, please don't make any structural parts out of PLA, because in only a matter of a couple hours, your PLA part can entirely transform. Let's talk about real engineering materials. Let's start off with ABS. ABS, next to PLA, is one of the most common materials printed on the desktop. Here at Airwolf, we were one of the first companies 5 years ago in this industry to start printing with ABS on the desktop. Why? Because ABS is a strong material, but it is a stable material also. It can be sanded, it can be painted. It's used in numerous automotive, industrial, and home applications. You can find ABS in all sorts of parts. Now, when printing with ABS, please keep in mind that there are several things your printer needs to have to get the best quality parts. First, you need to print generally at 240°C or higher. Your printing bed needs to be at 120°C or higher, and you should really have a closed environment to avoid cracking and warping. Finally, we use Wolf Bite on our glass bed to adhere the ABS and to minimize the chance of warping on the part. With those criteria taken care of, you can produce very nice end-use products with ABS. As a matter of fact, we optimized the Axiom 3D printer for printing in ABS with the enclosed environment. Now for the real test. How does ABS compare to PLA? As ABS and PLA are the most frequently used materials, which one is stronger? Let's watch the video. So as you notice, the ABS hook snapped right away. We didn't bother to reduce the weight on the hook because we're interested in finding out the ultimate 3D printing material. With that said, you can increase the cross-sectional area of your ABS hook to make it as strong as you need. And the beauty of ABS is it's easy to print, it lasts for a long time, and it's easily workable, meaning sandable, paintable, etc. But ABS does have a lower tensile strength than PLA. In fact, ABS's strength is 4,700 PSI compared to PLA, which comes in at 7,250 PSI. But we're really here to find the strongest desktop 3D printing material, and ABS and PLA aren't gonna cut it. So what's up next? There is a wonderful material that I'm sure you all have heard of, and it's called nylon. But nylon is traditionally very difficult to print on the desktop. At Airwolf 3D, we did a number of things to solve that. First, we invented a material called nitro, Wolfbite Nitro. This is applied to the surface of the bed. The bed is kept between 70 and 100 C, and the part is printed on between 250 and 270 C. We've been using nylon and Airwolf 3D to make functional parts of our 3D printers since 2014, and this nylon gear is a great example of it. We've printed thousands of these gears, and they are some of the strongest and most reliable components of our 3D printers. So after that brief description of nylon, let's take a look at the video and see how it performs as a hook. Now looking at the video, nylon is a great material to make structural parts with. The nylon hook lasted much longer than the ABS or the PLA parts. That's because nylon has a very high tensile strength. Nylon, in fact, is rated for 7,000 PSI compared to 4,700 PSI for ABS. And one of the beautiful things about nylon is when it breaks, it doesn't give right away. It slowly elongates into a predictable failure. Notice how the hook initially bent, but didn't yield until hundreds of pounds later. While the PLA hook broke at 285 pounds, our nylon hook lasted until 485 pounds. As we can see, nylon is a predictable material that works great in load applications. In fact, every Airwolf printer built since 2014 uses nylon gears for incredible reliability and precision. But we're not here just to talk about nylon. We're here to find the strongest desktop 3D printing material. And no discussion would be complete without a mention of polycarbonate. At Airwolf 3D since 2014, with the introduction of the Airwolf HDX, we've been printing polycarbonate extensively. Polycarbonate prints at 290 to 315 C with a bed temperature of 145 C. We'll use Wolfbite Mega to adhere the polycarbonate parts to the glass printing surface. Now, polycarbonate is a very strong material to work with. This, in fact, is made out of polycarbonate right here. And one of my favorite things to do with polycarbonate to demonstrate its strength is to drop it, or to throw it, or to bounce it off cement floors, because polycarbonate is very difficult to break. Now you see, after bouncing this hook, it looks identical to how it looked before. You just can't do that with other materials. So the question is, it looks great here. We use it in our printers all the time. We've been printing with the material since 2014, but how much weight can we lift with this tiny hook? Let's take a look at the video and find out. Polycarbonate is the undisputed king of desktop 3D printing materials. Not only is it incredibly strong, it prints great, it also has a great heat deflection temperature. In comparison to nylon, polycarbonate has a tensile strength of 9,800 PSI, whereas nylon is only at 7,000 PSI. When we designed the Axiom 3D printer, we designed it to print materials like polycarbonate. We designed it to print these materials for hours and hours at a time in a very hot environment. And that is how you achieve the uniform finish and the strength throughout the part when printing polycarbonate. So can you believe it? We lifted 685 pounds with this tiny polycarbonate hook. In summary, polycarbonate is the undisputed king of desktop 3D printing materials. To get this spool of filament free, go to airwolf3d.com/free shipping.
And get a free wolf bite.